games have been in existence for thousands of years, and today people are engaging in a good game of chess, Monopoly, Scrabble, and many, many more than ever before. Where there's a new book out that focuses on the history of board games going back to ancient times. Joining me to tell us more is Ian Livingstone. Ian, welcome to the show. How are you today?
I'm great, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. As I just shared with you, I'm so excited to chat with you. I think when I think back to my childhood, so many of my memories, so many of my favorite aspects were around games. Candyland, Chutes and Ladders, the list goes on and on. What inspired you to tackle this and go back all these years ago to give us an idea about board games?
Well, I've been a games player, games maker, games businessman for many years. Played games my whole life. And through that, and collecting games, I've seen an extraordinary number of games that people don't even know about, and just realize how important it has been to the culture of in which we live, and just seeing, you know, games have been around for thousands of years. So Senet, for example, invented 5,000 years ago, was played by Tutankhamun in Egypt, and when he died, he had four sets of Senet interned with him in his tomb, and when that was opened, they were discovered. So it's a fantastic phenomenon and things which I enjoy doing.
So I'm curious, there's so many things I want to chat with you. One of the things that caught my eye was how some of the games have morphed. And I think I mentioned Chutes and Ladders is one of my favorite. That used to have a different take, didn't it, Ian?
Yeah. Yes, I mean, it was. That's actually come from India, from Sanskrit time, from hundreds of years ago, from like mentioned in books from about 1230, I think it was. And it wasn't just Chutes in those days. It was a kind of a moral tale of what things could happen to you if you did bad things, and it's kind of a game of morality. And all these games have some sort of different impact from the old days. There's some strange games that talk about being able to people to learn strange facets of mathematics. But I like the more social side. The game goes to great lengths to talk about the people behind the games, some of the great stories and some of the tragic stories of people who have been really successful and not successful in games. Some of the household games that we now know and play, the original creators were not very, didn't benefit that much from them.
Huh, that's really interesting. Well, two of the ones that almost, you say, didn't get off the ground or perhaps fizzled, I believe is the word. Twister, that is such a classic game. That almost didn't happen.
Well, it almost didn't happen. It was originally called Pretzel, and it got renamed by Milton Bradley as Twister, but it wasn't very successful, and they were about to pull the whole line, but their PR company had already had it booked to be played on the Johnny Carson show, and he played it with Eva Gabor, and they were entwined, of course, on the floor. The nation was enthralled. It sold out the next day. And suddenly they had to start making 40,000 copies a week to keep up with the demand. So that's how, you know, one event can change the whole lifetime of an opportunity. In that case was Twister.
Well,
games like Scrabble, invented by an architect, Alfred Butts, he called it crisscross words. He wasn't successful, he made copies, he tried, he eventually got a job and ended up selling it to a colleague of his who changed the name to Scrabble. Fortunately, the chairman of Macy's played a copy of his game, ordered 2,500 copies, sold out. He licensed it to Celsius and Richter, and they had to make 2 million copies just to keep up with the demand. So the original creator didn't succeed, somebody else did. I mean, that's the story, that's the game of life in many ways.
Well, Ian, unfortunately, we are out of time, but of course, you can get the book for yourself. Of course, it's Board Games and 100 Moves, 8,000 Years of Play. Ian, I really appreciate your time. We could have chatted more, but have a good one and keep playing, right?